Starting from the bank view, you can see all the processing for the 12 channels associated with the faders directly below that screen. These are shown in signal path order from the top to the bottom of the screen. If you cannot see bank view, you may have a window open. You can close this by pressing the X in the top right hand corner of that screen. You can jump straight to any of the processing section of any of the visible channels by touching that processing block. To access the processing of any channel not visible in bank view, select the layer the channel is assigned to and it will appear on the screen. At the top of the channel strip, we find the preamp section. Source select allows you to choose the source for the input, including the local inputs, S-Link port, or I/O cards. Touching the library button allows you to recall one of the deep preamp emulations, such as the dual stage valve if you have the DPAC upgrade. By touching the filter tab at the top of the screen, we can quickly access the filter settings. Every input on Avantis has both a low and a high pass filter. The high pass filter slope can be selected from one of the four options. The next tab is the gate. The gate parameters can be adjusted on the screen by using the gate, compressor, rotary encoder mode, or by assigning gate parameters to the fast grab tab. Avantis features two insert points per channel, one before the PEQ and compressor and one afterwards. Here we can assign a physical insert, dynate, or an insert from the effects rack. The next tab is the 4-band PEQ. This EQ can be adjusted either by moving the parameters on the screen, selecting the parameter and using the screen encoder, or by using the channel encoders by assigning PEQ to a rotary encoder mode. The next tab shows the compressor options. The compressor parameters can be changed by selecting the desired parameter on the screen and turning the screen encoder, by using the gate compressor rotary encoder mode, or by assigning parameters to the fast grab tab. The order of the PEQ and compressor can be swapped by touching and holding the options button followed by channel options. In this menu, you can swap the PEQ and compressor order for that specific channel or globally for the entire console. The last processing tab is the delay tab. This can be used for time aligning different inputs coming into the console. By touching and holding the options button and pressing the overlay, you can choose to delay the inputs in meters, feet, milliseconds, or samples. We'll cover all of the processing blocks in detail in future videos.